the car doesn't break and they've done their work, then they'll go out on the racetrack.
Coming into the race, I'm pretty nervous, actually.
Scrutineering, where we take the car apart, put it back together again, and make sure she still runs before they can proceed to the American Solar Challenge.
Being on a Lion-Eye solar car means having a group of passionate people working with you towards the same goal.
In our case, we had three things happen simultaneously to stop this from working. So essentially, all of it is just learning from all the mistakes that are made. This is not something any engineer wants to go through again.
At the Heartland Motorsports Park in Topeka, Kansas, a dozen teams qualify to compete at the Formula Sun Grand Prix.
This is timing. Is the plan for Cyrene to continue to drive for the rest of the day?
That is the plan timing.
This three-day competition determines who will move on from the cross-country American Solar Challenge. The car with the most laps in the front, the slowest in the back. Students don't just have to manage their energy input, but also their emotions.
Talk into your radio.
He's getting his compensation.
I think we just have to deal with
it. We need to get the laps meter.
That's what matters.
Follow the rules, young man.
In 2021, only 9 teams qualified to continue on the American Solar Challenge. The pressure to make the most laps is intense. Teams that don't make the minimum required laps are disqualified. This is MIT, the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. They are the reigning champions and determined to hold on to their crown. Despite this, they struggle to exit the pits.
I'm Sydney. I'm vice captain of the MIT Solar Car team. So I handle a lot of the organization. There's a lot of things that go into an event like this that you don't think about.
All right, now translate backwards.
All right, I need everyone who's not holding something to grab.
Horses, we're coming this way.
In the car driving, make a left turn. Come this way.
All right, back over. Yes, yes, yes.
Here, we're going to get the horses.
All right, team, we need fairing screwdrivers. Tape off. Get off the fairing.
Can I have one of the screwdrivers, please?
Managing a team of 25 for 2 weeks as you travel across the country with a solar-powered car, a little more complex than I anticipated. I'm running Hot Pit. Hot Pit manages the operation, so I am talking to the solar car and timing and scoring and the whole rest of the team on this radio.
When you are at the top, the pressure only increases. For a veteran team like MIT, perfection is not just a goal, it's mandatory. In the world of solar racing, being the fastest does not always determine the winner. Like life, it's all about pacing. Teams can have the slowest top speed, yet maintain consistency and win the race. This is the strategy Principia College has taken to heart.
Woo! Let's go!
We're hoping to keep pace with the other teams. Stay in first place, that's the goal.
There's kind of two ways to win. You just are more time on the track. You run, you never break down, you never stop. Or you kind of want to go fast too to get most laps in a set period of time. Hot pit to solar car, hot pit to solar car, you're doing great. How do you feel?
I'm 3:53.
All right, so she did that in 3:53, and our target time right now is 4 minutes. So that's pretty good.
These water pumps do more than keep the cars looking shiny. For these vehicles, too much sun drains performance and drops charging efficiency, sapping crucial racing power. Keeping cool is essential to making it through the day. As MIT catches up, the University of Illinois heads into the pit to recharge their batteries. Time is of the essence. Every second wasted will jeopardize their ranking as head of the pack.
Before we close the top door,
I can help you.
Copy that.
Copy that.
Within the first 2 days, both MIT and Illinois are on track to qualify. However, not all teams have gotten off so scot-free.
This year, we have 10 teams that are in this event that have all successfully passed minimum laps for the American Solar Challenge in the first day, except one.
Timing to garage.
Illinois State University struggled to pass inspection.
The solar cells are inefficient, but they're there. So we've acquired an old mechanical platform from ISU team. I work on some of our own electrical system.
The goal is just to keep consistent laps on the track so we can get our times going.
Just as Principia secures the lead, an unknown error threatens to take them out of the race. One of their drivers has unknowingly committed a serious violation by passing another car in the pit crew lane.
What would you assume a valid penalty would be for that?
It's against the rule. You're not supposed to.
Yeah.
What did you do wrong?
After returning to the pit to discuss the infraction with officials, they are fortunate to escape with a warning.
Just want to make sure you're aware.
Still, they must fight to make up for lost time.
Much better.
That was the goal.
But we were going a little bit faster.
I think we passed them two or three times.
They just finished the lap, I think. So they're one ahead of us.
They got one back.
And also, I checked the regs. If we tie on laps, the tiebreaker is hot lap time, which we can't beat them.
We cannot, no.
Like, we need to get the laps on them. We can't do a hot lap faster than them.
You guys are doing really great with these hot laps. Just as an update though, you do have 15 minutes left until the end of race.
Let's go!
No, I don't have any favorites. I can't have favorites. I've got to be an unbiased judge in this event, so I can't have favorites, even if I did.
Meanwhile, over at the Texas garage,
that is our chief engineer. He was with me until 2 a.m.
Our backup plan is to get a bunch of lead acid batteries and not use this whole setup.
We stripped away a quarter of our battery pack to make everything work. Now we gotta put it all back together and not break anything while we assemble all of these wires such that it still works when it's in the box.
I definitely have ideas on what I'm gonna do next time for the next design to make this easier for maintenance, because this is not something any engineer wants to go through again.
As day 3 of the Grand Prix arrives, each team approaches their final 8 hours of laps. In 3 days, they have driven over 700 miles with an average of 3 minutes per lap. MIT frantically guns for first position, with Kentucky and Illinois attempting to overtake, winding in and out of corners, flipping apexes. The roar of the crowd intensifies to a climax as Principia College wins the Formula Sun Grand Prix. Texas and Illinois State did not meet the requirements, sending them home. For the qualifying teams, this is just the beginning.
In first place for the SOV class, with 299 laps, 747 miles completed, team number 32, Principia!
Now, a higher glory awaits in the main event.
I can't believe we did 300 laps. That's insane.
We drove 100 laps, and then we drove 100 laps.
Over the next 8 days, these teams will embark on a journey to win the American Solar Challenge crown.